Hey, and here's your third example. Okay, so we're going to work out x-intercept, we're going to work out the y-intercept, we'll work out the turning point, and then we'll sketch a graph out. Okay, so the first thing we'll do is work out the x-intercept, okay, and obviously you'll now not remember that's known as the roots. And hopefully remember that's when y equals 0. So we'll just write out y equals x minus 3, x plus 5, but y is equal to 0 when it crosses the x-axis, so 0 equals x minus 3, x plus 5, and we can see there's going to be two roots, okay, so x can take two values. So what we'll look at is how we make this part 0, so root 1, we'll just call it, and that is x minus 3 equals 0. Add 3 to both sides to make it in terms of x, so x equals 3. Okay, so the first root is at position 3, 0. Second root, so it's the second part of this, is root 2, and we'll say that x plus 5 equals 0. Need to take away 5 from both sides, so we've got x equals minus 5, and we've got another root at minus 5, 0. So it's a wee bit different in terms of we've got a root, a minus x, and then we've got the other one, a positive x. But that's the x-intercept. Work out the y-intercept, even simpler. So y-intercept, so I'll just write that out, maybe choose a different color. Y-intercept is when x is equal to 0. So that's when x equals 0. So we've got this old equation again, x minus 3, x plus 5, but now we know that these x's are going to be 0, so y equals 0 minus 3, which is minus 3. 0 plus 5 is 5. So we've now know y intercept is at 15. So the whole coordinate is x is 0 and it's minus 15. So that's these are your roots. So it crosses the x-axis at 3, 0, minus 5, 0, and this is where it crosses the y-axis at 0, minus 15. We can then work out the turning point. So if I now go up to just say call this 3. Now the x, so the turning point, okay, x coordinate is when it's root 1 plus root 2, divide that by 2. Okay, so we know root 1, just call that 3, plus minus 5, divide by 2. Now you could, before going on to this bit, start sketching out and you'll actually be able to estimate, and it would be an estimate with your eyes whereabouts the turning point, but obviously you want to work it out. So x equals, so what you've got is 5, no sorry, 3 minus 5, which is minus 2, over 2, which is minus 1. So this is the turning point x coordinate. Now to find the y coordinate, all we need to then do there is remember we've got this, we always go back to the initial equation, and then we substitute x for minus 1, or minus 1 for x even. So y equals minus 1 minus 3 minus 1 plus 5. So that minus 1 minus 3 is minus 4. And that's going to be times by minus 3 plus 5, that is 4. So the y coordinate is going to be minus 16. So overall, the turning point coordinates are going to be minus 1 and minus 16. Now we just need to sketch this out. So I'll move this along. It's going to be a bit of a squeeze. Not the best start there. Right, so drawing the line up here. Obviously, you'll have a ruler and hopefully be doing a better job than I'm doing. Right, then a line there. Right, so choose a different colour. Right, so here's one of the routes. It crosses at minus 5. Another one crosses at 3. Okay, so that's 3-0, minus 5-0. So that's us plotted these, that one and that one. Y-intercept is minus 15. So in reality, I should really extend this just to make it look a bit in proportion. It's my worst yet. Right, so that's about, to see minus 15's about here. Your turning point, what did we say? That was minus 1, which is about here. So that's slightly your axis of symmetry, minus 16, which is here. Okay, so that's your turning point, minus 1, minus 16. And now to try and draw this. Just seen my other videos uploaded. Right. That goes down here. Then crosses here and then it goes all the way back up. It's not the best, right? And that's where it's, in theory, where it's symmetrical, right? Down here. Wish this would stop jumping about. But that's essentially the answer to that question. Okay, so always refer back to the actual equation. Work out the x-intercept, work out the y, work out the turning point, sketch it. If they ever ask you what is the line of symmetry, it's basically where it crosses the x-intercept. So in this case, x equals minus 1. Then we'll look at questions in which it gives you it in a different form, but that's essentially all you need to know with that. So hopefully that's helped.